Mostly in India, when we have discussions like this, there is a preponderance of opinions and emotions and a dearth of data. So as a moderator, I'm not going to express opinions, nor am I going to give you silver bullets, but I'm going to set the scene by sharing some data with you. When we talk of rural reform, let us understand India. Of the, in the 2011 census, we counted that there were 1.2 billion Indians, 121 crores. And how many of the Indians live in rural areas and how many in urban areas? And the number is staggering. 83.3 crores live in rural areas and 37.7 live in urban areas. Also, 300 million Indians were below the poverty line. At that time, it was, of course, the World Bank data. Then you had the Dr. Suresh Tendulkar committee, which moved away from income to how people spend money, and that was 33 rupees per day in urban areas and 27 in rural. That went into a firestorm because some politicians felt that this was this complicated formula. By the way, Dr. Tendulkar was a very eminent professor, a PhD from Harvard. He'd done a lot of work to create this formula. But then the Rangarajan Committee was again, within 2 years, formed. And we are now moving to the international way of measuring poverty, and that is relative poverty. Europe, as you know, they say if anybody is below 60% of the median income, which is relative, then they are poor. In the US, it's 40%. So the Rangarajan Committee has moved away from Tendulkar Committee, but regardless of what committee and what measure you use, we have a vast number of people who are very poor. Also, I think if you look at India, the main issues still remain. That is access. Access to water, access to sanitation, access to health, education, banking and credit, access to market, access to internet. And this lack of access is actually a death spiral, which is creating a situation where while we have pulled a lot of people out of poverty, there are still many people below the poverty line by whichever way you calculate. The last thing I would say before I would begin asking a few questions and let the speakers make their introductory remarks is that the real root cause of poverty in rural India is that a huge number of people are engaged in agriculture. And the productivity in agriculture is low. There are too many people. 65% of India's population depends on agriculture. It produces between 25 and 27%, whichever way you calculate the GDP. And therefore, that arithmetic will tell you why there's poverty in rural India. And unless we break from this cycle, it is going to be difficult. Of course, we have 100 smart cities coming up. We have calculation that by 2050, most of the rural areas will become, people will live in urban agglomerations. But we have to deal with the reality now. Unless we are able to carry out meaningful rural reforms, we will remain a rich country with poor people, and our productivity will be low. We will have the tribal population in abject poverty. So access is access, equality, these are inclusion, these are very important issues.